Hi there, good afternoon everyone. This is Liz Davis. I am a nutritionist and I specialise in digestive health for busy women. So I help busy women fix their IBS symptoms, bloating, painful digestion, etc., etc. Any kind of related hormone issues, so perimenopause, menopause, bad periods, etc., all can be tied back to gut health in a large part normally. And I do this with state-of-the-art gut testing, hormone testing, and dietary and lifestyle upgrades to get things back into balance nicely for you. So today I was just going to do a quick run through on the gut-brain axis because it's super, super important. There's a huge link there between IBS symptoms and psychological issues such as depression, anxiety, etc. And it's not just an imaginary thing. It is really, you know, a real and tangible thing going on there, because the gut and the brain are always speaking to each other via the vagus nerve. And the gut actually has its own nervous system called the enteric nervous system. And this is linked to the brain via the vagus nerve. So when you, if you ever get that feeling like of apprehension, you've got butterflies in your tummy, you know, what you're feeling in your mind, you often feel in your gut as well, or you've got a gut feeling about something, that's your vagus and enteric nervous system kicking in there and sending signals backwards and forwards. So yeah, it's definitely real, definitely very tangible. So if this is you, if you're someone who gets IBS symptoms because you're anxious, then do know you're not alone. It's a real kind of common thing. And there are a few reasons behind this, which I will just go into shortly. But it's in large part as well to do with your microbiome. So the friendly bacteria you have living in your gut, and they are absolutely instrumental in your mood as well. Scientists have looked into this in great depth, and it's transpired that people who have a nice diverse range of different bacteria in their gut consequently do have better, more stable moods. So it's definitely, it is a real thing. So if we're looking at your bacteria, for example, your bacteria are going to do really important jobs. A lot of them will be sort of synthesizing serotonin. They're synthesizing GABA, which is another neurotransmitter, which helps you feel calm and relaxed. They're also manufacturing short chain fatty acids. You need plenty of those in your gut to reduce feelings of hunger, among many, many other jobs that they do. So it's, you know, it's really not surprising then that if you've got a depleted microbiome, and you've got a depleted microbiome as well, is always also going to give rise to IBS symptoms. So there's a kind of like a double whammy going on there. You've got a depleted microbiome, so that alone is causing symptoms of anxiety, depression, which can then have a knock-on effect on your gut. But not only that, but when you've got this depletion in your microbiome, then your bacteria just isn't doing what it's supposed to be doing as regards your digestion. So with serotonin, for example, you've got, serotonin is ubiquitous, you've got it all around your body. I think 80% of it is produced in your gut. So it's doing a very different job to in your gut to what it's doing in your brain. So in your brain, it's like your feel-good neurotransmitter. In your gut, it's helping you to regulate bowel movements, etc., avoiding constipation, diarrhea, that kind of thing. So it is something that needs to be regulated. So your body needs to keep it in check. So there you go. So that's a few examples of how your gut and your brain are very closely linked. So how do you keep this system healthy then? Well, basically what you want to be doing is avoiding processed foods as far as you can. So it has been shown in numerous studies that people who eat a wide variety of plant-based foods have a better, more diverse microbiome, so therefore less of these kind of depression and anxiety symptoms as well. So if you avoid ultra-processed foods with added sugar and lots of additives, sweeteners, etc., because they have a real negative impact on your microbiome, you need to be aiming for your 30 different plant foods every week. It sounds like a lot, but it's not really. If you count all the spice and herbs and everything else you eat, then it does kind of add up over the course of a week. So the second thing to do would be to include probiotic foods in your diet. So probiotic foods being stuff like natural yogurt, sauerkraut, kefir, milk kefir, water kefir, all great foods for providing plenty of friendly bacteria into your diet. And these can be, make sure you go easy on them though if you haven't, if you're not used to eating them, or if you suspect you've got candida or anything like that, do make sure that you've got the candida under control. Ditto, SIBO, anything like that can be aggravated by adding more bacteria in before your gut is ready to kind of have that stage of the treatment plan, if you like, going on. But if your gut is otherwise healthy, you're not bloating or yeasty or anything like that, then probiotic foods are going to be a great option for you. If you suspect you've got any of those other things, we can always chat about it. We can always get you tested and find out what's going on in there. Okay, so the next thing to do would be to avoid gluten. Not for everybody, but certainly some people find if they avoid gluten, they avoid all the kind of anxiety and depression symptoms that can go along with that sometimes. Sometimes you may not tolerate gluten that well. Some people find that their digestive system tolerates it. You may get skin issues, or mood issues. Those can all be a thing as well. So if you are suffering with anything, it's worth kind of doing a bit of experimentation and finding out if you avoid gluten, does it make you feel better? It could be you can tolerate certain types of gluten and not others. For example, you may tolerate sourdough perfectly well. You may be able to tolerate rye bread, for example, but not kind of commercial wheat bread or all that kind of thing. So it's worth experimenting just to find if you can get some kind of symptom relief there. The next thing to do would be absolutely not avoid healthy fats. Don't worry too much about fat making you fat, which has been drummed into us over the years. Focus though on healthy fats, oily fish, avocado, nuts, seeds, etc. The oily fish, for example, particularly is great at controlling inflammation throughout the body, and inflammation is closely linked to depression, anxiety, etc., as well as a whole host of other symptoms as well, which are best avoided. You're going to need your healthy fats for hormone production and for brain health and your skin health, etc. So don't sort of think that low fat is necessarily healthier for you. B vitamins are crucial for mind and mood. So they are kind of natural stress busters, all those vitamins as well. So you could supplement with a B complex. Make sure you do take a complex though. You want all of the B's in it because they all tend to work together. Or foods naturally high in B vitamins, such as green leafy vegetables, etc. Make sure you've got plenty of those going on to really help elevate your mood. Same with nuts. Nuts, walnuts, cashews, almonds. Again, these foods are rich in serotonin. And if you find that you're not digesting nuts so well at the moment, you can always try soaking them first just to make them a bit easier for you to digest. Okay, so that's the gut-brain connection explained to you. It's not just your imagination. There are a few foods that you can try and improve your gut health and get the neurotransmitters pumping a bit more efficiently. And if you do want to speak to me about any testing or coaching or anything like that, then do pop me a message. And also like and share if you found this useful. Okay, I shall see you next time. Bye.